Hi everybody, it's Miss Jenny. I'm going to do Jesus time with you today, so if you could get out your Bible books. Are you ready? The Bible is God's book. Let's open it and see. It tells us that God loves us. He loves you and 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 me. All right, boys and girls, last week we learned about a man named Philip who told someone about Jesus. The week before that, we learned about a man named Stephen who told lots of people about Jesus. Then this week, we're going to learn about a man named Paul. His name was Saul. First, his name was Saul, and he did not love God. And the people that were telling people about Jesus, he was not very nice to at all. And one day he was on the road on the way to a city called Damascus when a bright light shined down. And God said, was talking to Saul, and he said, "Why do you persecute me? Why are you so mean to the people that love me?" Then when the light went away, Saul couldn't see anymore. He was blind. His eyes weren't working right. So his friends, I have another picture here I'll show you. Look, he was on his way to Damascus, and a bright light shined down on him, and he was scared, and he didn't know what was happening. But his friends that were with him helped him get into the city of Damascus. And then God sent a man named Ananias to him. And when Ananias came to him and talked to him, he told him that he was not being kind to others, and that Jesus died on the cross for his sins too, even though he had made sad choices. And when Ananias touched his eyes, the scales fell off and Saul could see again. But now he wasn't called Saul anymore. He was called Paul. Paul loved God very much, and he told lots and lots and lots of people about Jesus. And he traveled the world telling people about Jesus. He was what we call a missionary. And he loved God very much. And he knew that with all the terrible, terrible things that he had done, if God could forgive someone like Paul, he could forgive everyone. So he told lots and lots of people about Jesus, and he loved God very much. Paul was an important missionary, and he even wrote some of the books of the Bible. And he loved God very much. God had converted him. We call that, it says an enemy converts on the top. That means he changed his heart. God changed Saul's heart to be a loving Paul, and he became Paul after that, and he traveled the world and told others about Jesus. Now, God also changes us. He puts his love in our hearts, and he shows us his love through sending Jesus to die on the cross for us, and he wants us all to tell others so we can tell others too, because we know how much God loves us. Our Bible passage this week is from 2 Corinthians. It says, "If anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation. Just like Saul that did sad things was gone. When he learned about Jesus, he was a new creation. He was new. He was Paul who loved God and showed God love in all he did." So God loves us, and so we can be a new creation too. If anyone is in Christ, he is a new creation. That's right. That's a wonderful thing to remember. Now, tomorrow you can do the family page, and you can talk about the different things that you can do at home or on the go. At mealtime, you can talk about how Saul was blind and he couldn't see. You could also, using chalk, make a heart and a cross on the sidewalk to show others about Jesus. This says you could talk about superheroes. Who's your favorite superhero? And you could remember that Jesus is our superhero, because he took away the sins of the whole world and he loves us so much. Jesus was a real superhero with the power to fight off sin, death, and the power of the devil. So those are some fun ideas that you can do at home with your mom and dad with your sheet, okay? Right now, let's go ahead and pray. Our hands we fold, our heads we bow, so we can talk to God right now. Dear Jesus, I'm glad you loved Saul so much that you changed him from an enemy into a friend. Thank you for loving me so much, too, and for calling me to be your child. Amen. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. These words are written that we may believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Would you guys like to sing a song with me? It's one of my very favorites, and my class loves it so much. It's called Thy Word. You ready? Get out your Bible books, ready?
Thy Word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. Thy Word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. When I feel afraid and I think I've lost my way, still you're there right beside me. Never will I fear as long as you are near. Please be near me to the end. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light.
Thanks for joining me for Jesus time.